All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Karim Rayani. He's the CEO of Falcon Gold. And Karim, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Hi, Steve. Good to see you.
So company's put out a bit of an update. It's obviously been a very busy summer for Falcon Gold. So there's a few things to go over with you. First off, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about Central Newfoundland. It continues to be a very important area for Falcon Gold. Can you sort of give us a bit of an update?
Yeah, so I guess over the last year, we've acquired about 149,000 hectares when you combine it with our sister company, Marvel Discovery. We've acquired, going after, you know, major structures, you know, tied onto larger deposits. So, you know, we're, you know, in the south, you know, Central Newfoundland, tied onto Benton Sokimon's lithium discovery. You know, we believe that we have an extension onto that. We're also on the north portion, 25 kilometers east of the Queensway deposit, which is Newfound Gold. I think most of your viewers would know Newfound. You know, they hit a massive hole, and you know that's really what created a staking frenzy. From that, the billionaire investor Eric Sprott has put in roughly $200 million, acquiring 30% of Newfound Gold. He's also acquired a number of, he's also taken positions in a number of other companies in Newfoundland.
Yeah, so obviously, once the name Sprott comes into an area, it obviously is a pretty big deal. And you feel that Falcon is set up to sort of take advantage of that and start working that property?
Yeah, I mean, you know, most of the plays in Newfoundland, you know, they're all a relatively early stage. You know, Newfound, you know, hit a, you know, a massive hole, and that obviously created a whole, you know, new movement. Gander Gold, which was formerly Sassy, is directly tied onto our ground. You know, they completed some soils, 800 ppb in soils. We have an extension or a splay that we believe that goes right across into our ground. You know, we're tied into Hope Brook, you know, multi-million ounce deposits down there on both the north and south portion. We're tied on to Gander Gold. We're also in the Bay Verte district, where all of Newfoundland's production comes out of. You know, we've been fairly undervalued the last, you know, year. Our share price is up roughly, you know, 40% plus, trading very strong in the U.S. over the last few days. And I think that's really just, you know, because people are starting to take notice as to the assets we have. Of paramount importance, we're doing a plan of arrangement spin out of our Argentinian asset. We have an AGM coming up on the 10th next week. And then we'll, move to get that company listed as a wholly owned sub and, you know, focus on Latin America. So there's, you know, lots of opportunity right now with Falcon, and, that's where, you know, the activity is coming from, I believe.
And will you be getting onto, as far as, you know, some work on those Newfoundland properties? Are you hoping to be drilling this year? Is that really sort of the plan to start pretty well get going next year?
Yeah, we've got crews mobilized on multiple projects. Once we get the assays back and we complete trenching, et cetera, we'll put our permitting in. Newfoundland's fairly quick, so hopefully, you know, we're trying to move as quickly as we can and drill, you know, this summer. So, you know, we'll see how fast we get the permits.
All right. It's going to be a busy time, as I mentioned. Karim, thank you so much for the update. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Steve.
All right. Karim Rayani, the CEO of Falcon Gold.